Straddling the United States-Mexico border lies the Chihuahuan Desert. It is an arid landscape littered with spiked brush and fierce cactus thorns. The area is marked by wild swings in temperature. A blistering sun produces triple digits by day, and chilly evening winds rushing through the ravines and canyons can drop temperatures by more than 60 degrees at night.
Snakes are probably hiding all over this place.
The desert is crawling with over 105 species of snakes, including the deadly western diamondback rattlesnake. At up to 5.5 feet long, it is the largest rattler in the West and uses a forked tongue to smell potential prey. Dan has done extensive desert research for potential threats, but coming from a tropical climate, he lacks hands-on experience surviving in brutal desert conditions. Dan begins with the PSR, or primitive survival rating, given to him at the end of his fan challenge, 6.5. Meghan's mental strength has gotten her through many harsh challenges in life, but will she have the physical strength to endure a marathon survival challenge stripped of everything? Meghan begins with a PSR of 5.9.
Good morning!
Oh my gosh, is that my partner? I'm so excited to meet you!
Me too. What's your name?
Meghan.
Dan.
Dan, nice to meet you. Are you excited?
I'm so excited.
We're gonna rock this.
I can't wait to get out there.
Heck yeah. Well, we're out here.
We're out here already, you're right. It's toasty already, man.
Yeah, it is. The ground's getting a little warm already. Uh-huh. Have you ever been in the desert like this before?
I've been to the desert, but not that much.
I'm from Arizona, so I'm used to the desert.
Oh, perfect. I'm from Hawaii. So opposite.
Totally not anything like this.
My background's all marine biology.
Oh my gosh. Well, hopefully you've got some cool marine biology knowledge.
Yeah, I'll whip out all my fish knowledge as we're walking through the desert. Megan's good. I'm happy that she's my partner. She has experience out in the desert, which I don't. So it's definitely a good compliment to my skills. All right, let's see what we got here.
Awesome.
Meghan and Dan have each brought a personal item, a knife and a fire starter. And they've been given a pot to boil water.
Now let's take a look at our map.
Hopefully there's some water nearby.
So we're all the way up there. There's extraction.
Okay, looks like some water here.
It's gonna be what we aim for, but yep. There's rattlesnakes and scorpions and
a whole lot of cactus.
Every other spiky thing in the world in between us and there.
We're gonna have to go through it to get there. All right, well, you ready?
I'm ready.
Cool.
Let's do it.
I don't think we're gonna be able to build a permanent shelter tonight because it's already afternoon.
Okay. It looks like there's a nice spot under that tree we might wanna take advantage of. For tonight, we're not gonna have any type of nice shelter. We don't have the time, the energy, or the resources, so I'm pretty nervous about how the night's gonna go.
We are exhausted. All right. I've got my fire going.
Oh, that's great.
Our feet hurt, backs hurt. But we're just trying to get this done as fast as we possibly can so that we can have somewhere survivable to sleep tonight. It's not gonna be the most comfortable night, but
no.
At least it should block some of the wind.
I thought there'd be not many bugs out here, but I'm in a swarm of gnats.
They are all over the place.
As the temperature drops and humidity rises, tiny blood-sucking gnats move freely in the moist air. They're attracted to body heat, sweat, and other sources of moisture.
They go in your nose, in your belly button, in your places you don't want them. It's just a little too much for me. I'm really hoping they go away when the sun goes down.
So it's the first night and I'm coated in bug bites. Every 5 minutes, I'm waking up to smack a bug off of me.
Ants and gnats up my nose, in my ear.
The smoke kind of helps repel the bugs a little bit, but these bugs are driving me crazy. Not having a good time.
I'm feeling really exhausted. I was covered in ants the entire night.
Meghan's already feeling sick from just when she woke up. It's gonna get worse when the sun comes up soon.
I know.
Bugs last night were driving her crazy, but I haven't gotten bit by a single ant.
Insects are attracted to chemicals like lactic acid, which some people produce more than others, making them more prone to bites.
You need to get a cozy shelter up here, and hopefully we can give her a place to just ride out the wall she's hitting right now.
For us to keep all the thorns and bugs out and be able to rebuild into shelter, we have to scorch the ground.
Burning the ground will kill any existing bugs and create wood ash that can act as a repellent for ants and other crawling insects.
Basically, we're just containing the fire and keeping it just on the ground where we're going to be sleeping.
Meghan and I are switching on and off, monitoring it to make sure it doesn't get too far, but really scorches the ground as much as possible. I'm going to notch the tree. Meghan's gonna make some nice yucca cordage, really strong bind. And then we're gonna lay a couple other ones that are similar shaped and make a big kind of hut. It'll be nice and insulated.
Dan and Meghan are rebuilding their shelter into a dome, using branches as the shell. They will then layer it with sheets of bark to insulate them from the elements.
I'm gonna start helping you lash some stuff down.
Thanks.
I think it looks good. I think this is actually gonna do us pretty well.
This is our shelter. It's coming along. I'm thirsty. Be right back. Oh, shit.
Are you okay?
Huge snake.
Oh, it's over there by the tree.
Oh.
Oh, my God. Yes!
Woo! Okay. I just whipped it around a bit.
That was incredible.
Dan has caught a Western coach whip, a non-venomous snake that's one of the fastest snakes in North America.
You rock, dude.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Yes. That's so much freaking meat. The amount of protein that comes from this snake is just incredible. I think we'll probably have energy for a few days off of this. I'm not really sure if I can do this.
Just give it a couple days. I've been where you are. I think it's better. I don't know what to do. It's scary. It's really scary, the thought of being out here alone.
I'm exhausted, and I was just trying to get through one more day. I just want a bed and some food, and I want the bug to go away. I don't want to sleep in a pile of ants. It hurts and it keeps me up all night, and I haven't been able to get any sleep or even any rest during the day because they're just all over me. I guess I'm saying I have to tap out.
I think you'll regret doing that.
I don't want to give up, but I don't feel like I have a choice. I feel like I failed, and I did. I failed. I guess I'm just like not a survivalist.